Shema Live in Washington, D.C.
It's a White House.
If Trump gets in office, we are all, the world will go to hell.
The whole thing with the emails is, it's ridiculous. This is just to get everybody, you know, in the press talking and talking and talking. Because what needs to be done, and this is what I'm really working at the IMF, my workplace, my complaint for workplace bullying at the IMF, is to try and get them to clean up all of these little, you know, queen for a day, a king for a day, civil servants that just are playing with people's lives. I'm going through that in the D.C. courthouse. I'm going through that in the IMF. I just went to the election, not to let to vote. I already voted for Clinton. But they were playing that downtown as well. I lived outside of the United States for 20 years, came back a decade, right after Obama was in office, and everybody, rah, rah, rah. I said, he doesn't have any magic wands. And for a decade, I've been watching and reading everything while everybody in this town is partying, 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 just like they did in the 80s when I left. I'm not putting everything up, not even understanding what they're reading. People have to stop with the partying, stop with the wine, stop with the food, get back to their offices and start reading what they should be reading, and everybody start doing their jobs and get rid of all of these excess people in all of these agencies. There's infection now. Thanks. Vote Clinton.
Llevo 19 días hoy en huelga de hambre. Y es la segunda. La primera la hice del 8 de junio al 12 de julio del 2016. Me desmayé ahí en el parque. Al 12 de julio del 2016. Me desmayé ahí en el parque.
My name is Michael Steinberg, and I'm a candidate for Vice President of the United States, and I'm running with the Reform Party, the American Delta Party, and also with an independent with presidential candidate Rocky De La Fuente. My issue is Social Security and veterans benefits, and I'm hoping to help make sure that Social Security is solvent, that we pay people disability benefits who deserve it, and make sure that the veterans get speedy decisions in their compensation and pension plans. I think those are the two issues that haven't been addressed by the major political parties, and we need to do something to fix those two programs. And I appreciate your vote. And if you don't vote for me, I'd appreciate you contacting your congressman and your senator to tell them to address those issues. Thanks a lot.
People who owe the money, and then it makes it look like you're balancing. What are you doing? Just denying money.
The Board of Veterans Appeals is right over.
Around that time, there was a group that came through with Make America Great Again, Donald Trump things. And there was one black person, no Latinos, no Asians, no Native Americans in this group. But there was one black person. And I sometimes get food from Bonnie right up through the park. There's one lady down on Wednesdays at 7 o'clock passes out food from a Baptist church van. And this is a guy that goes up there and gets food. Well, they have this guy dressed up pretty nicely. And it's him, it's this guy. And he even said hello to me when he saw me because he's familiar with me. And I think that they paid a black guy to be the only black guy in their 70, maybe at the most 80% protest. So the one black guy, he stood out, and when I saw that there was one black guy, I looked, and it was somebody I knew, even him, you know, nodding to me.
Some people wonder how God could allow a 9/11 event to happen. Well, the Bible talks about promises that God sets up.
It's never boring near the White House.